Welcome everyone to Cattle and Crops. I'm going to plough, cultivate and fertilise and then finally seed wheat into Build 23. This is Cattle and Crops on Linux on a Radeon Vega 64 graphics card. This is version 0.96. I've just cleared the field of all current implements. As you can see, I had started, I'm going to restart. So, got partially ploughed, partially cultivated already. What you're seeing here is one of the new power harrows with comes with 0.9.6. See, it's quite smooth. I'm playing with a keyboard, so no steering wheel. No steam controller, this is the keyboard and mouse. The lines you're seeing in front of this tractor are all to do with the guidance system, we'll look at that later as we go through. First task is set the ploughing up. I'm going to use the two tractors we saw just now, and I've already got a task done, so we'll just copy this one. So the two tractors, two AI, set it to go immediately, two ploughs, we'll go into the northeast part of the build, and we'll tell it to go to the farm once it's complete. And then we'll click save, it should go. We'll just come out of there, back to the field, and we'll see these tractors move in a minute. They're thinking about how they're going to do it. There we go, the white lines are the AI's navigation paths. I've got the AI debug on, so we can see what paths it takes. So one of the other things I've got to do is we can have a look at this field. See nitrogen is down, but potassium and phosphorus are both really high, so when we fertilise, I only need to fertilise with nitrogen. So you can see the two tractors moving on, but one of the things we have to do now is might as well go and purchase the seeder. Yep, it's wheat, so I need a grain seed unit. I'll just buy that, it'll be at the vehicle trader, and we'll also buy the fertilizer unit. Has to be, this one has to go in front of the seeder, it's a double unit, and we're going to collect it and let the AI carry on with its ploughing. Well, we've still got the field lines on, so let's turn those off. That's a P key, bring it up, just to click it up, it's gone. And now let's quickly fast forward. Horrible noise. So this is fast forward on the video, not actually in game. This is me steering with the keyboard, of course. I think this is three times the motion. There we go, coming up to the vehicle trader. Now let's pick up the vehicles. Reverse onto this one, and we use the Q key to connect. Now we then pick up the seeding unit behind them. This unit, so we just pull forward, straighten up, and reverse back. Here's a sign of my capabilities, or not. Cruising away. There we go. Let's see how well I can line up. And We're there. Q to connect. And Q to disconnect. And Q to connect. There we go. Just to show how it works. Now I'll send this off to the to get seed and fertilizer, and we'll use the N key to tell the AI just drive there. Let's have a look at my field, see how it's getting on. Watch them plough. See how they're working together. One follows on behind the other. Seems to work very nicely. Should allow me to get through the field twice as fast. Ooh, looks like they're going to cross. Oh, look, both vehicles together. Oh, it's going to wait. Oh, close one. Oh, very close. Fairly clever AI in cattle and crops. You can just set it tasks and most of the time it'll do it correctly. Remember, this is an early access version, so not the release game. We're working on it all the time. So if you notice, he's going straight in the path of the next one, so we're getting a double path on each time. Perfectly lined up. Hopefully it will be an even flow now because we're onto the full stretches. So by the time this one gets to the end, that one will be turning around. And it should be now continuous. How's the say I got in? It's not quite to the shop. Okay, remember? This is the AI driving, hence the dots, not me. That's why it's not all over the place. It can stay in the lane. Doesn't cut corners, unlike me. Doesn't ignore traffic, unlike me. Doesn't drive across fields, unlike me. Well, I thought we were closer than we are. Yep, still moving on nicely. Wait till it hits the end and see how smooth it is. Very clever. So you turn the plough, rotate it out. Let's turn off the field, the AI nav. It's under gameplay, right at the bottom. There's a load of debug, AI nav debug. Now you won't see the dots. And now that's one that's way, let's go and look at the fertilizer and grain unit. First of all, we need to fill up the fertilizer. So we select fertilizer. We can't put wheat in the wrong unit, so if we click it, you'll see it says at the top incompatible, and then we can click start. So let's go down and find by nitrogen or urea. I know that's liquid, so we want the nitrogen chalk. We'll click start to fill. We're just going to fill it out completely. Plenty of money. Okay, now we need to can't select that because the grain unit's not in the fill area, so we'll just manipulate the vehicle to get them both in. And when you see it comes back up, both units are in, we get a drop down, actual drop down. So we'll click the grain unit. Now we can click wheat seed and we can fill it up. So what we need to do now is work out at what rate we need to fill our fertilizer at. So we're currently, for wheat we need 120 kilograms per hectare, and we've currently got just under 60. So we need about 60 kilograms per hectare, and we've got 2 hectares in this field. So we need 120 hectares, basically 120 kilograms. So what does that mean for us? So if we're going to look at the calculator that's on the wall here, we just look. So we'll choose our nitrate chalk we put in, N27. And as we click up, going, we need to get that to around 60. There we go. So 250 kilograms would give us 60. So we'd need 100, double that because we've got 2 hectares. We can go down a bit. It's cheap, don't scrimp. We filled up anyway, so it doesn't matter, but that gives us our rate basically. So around 220 kilograms per hectare of fertilizer should bring our field up by about 60. So if I go back in the vehicle, we hit the middle mouse button, we get the wheel up, go E, and on the right hand side at 3 o'clock we can scroll that back to it's around 220, there you go, 225. So that will lay 225 kilograms per hectare. That should bring my field up to around about 120 kilograms per hectare needed of nitrogen for summer wheat. So we'll just drive this vehicle back. I won't drive it back, we'll get the AI to do it. All those orange lights. So we send it down to the field. Up, no, let's send it to the farm instead, and then I can at least refuel it, make sure it's all topped up, and then we'll just hit N and the AI will head on back. Roof. Okay, the back. It's noisy when you open the back. Adjust all the mirrors. And away we go. Let's go and have a look at our field. And just quickly save the game and fast forward through it. While that continues, we'll go and collect the cedar and bring it across, ready for the later tasks. Turn off the flashing, fill up with diesel. Disconnect. Go over and have a look. And let's see him drive past in normal speed. Speed mode and zoom along. Come up to the last few lengths of the field. Start doing the hits anytime. band box just to get in.
So we can
something. Just bumped it away. So, using two ploughed AI ploughing, knees stretch, strip around, build, pump it out. Broken AI. Let's have a look at the field now. As we can see, it's now got ploughed and it's 100%. Excellent. So let's now go and do the cultivation. I'm not going to use the AI for cultivating it. I'm actually going to do it by hand because I want to try out the new power harrow that came out with this version of the game. 6 meter wide, should go through quite fast. I'm not going to do a headland, I'm going to go up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. But I'm also going to use the field guidance, so that's the V to drop it down just to show how low it goes. Let's line it up. Bring up the field guidance system using the P key. Turn it on. Oh, you can see its track. Didn't put the handbrake on and I was just edging forward. Handbrake. That's the space bar. Just the line, switch the auto tracking steering on. Doesn't look like it's lined up perfectly with the implement, so let's just check it. Seems to be. Maybe that's just a graphical glitch. Drop it down with the V and off we go. Oh, it's not actually working. It's a power harrow. It needs to be switched on. So let's just go back again. Turn it on with B and then drop it down and off we go again. So there we go. Now we can see it's doing the whole 6 meter width. Use the T key to put on the cruise control and now I'm hands off. The cruise control is taking us forward and the field navigation is actually steering for me, and you can see the steering wheel in the display. It must have hit a stone. Definitely hit a rock or something. So go back, realign. Might have to go a bit faster. Bump it over and make sure we knock it out of the way. There we go. So we'll drive a bit faster. Control back on, and I'm going to increase its speed so it's not interfered with by stones and rocks as much. There's no one there, it auto corrected it. All I'm going to do now is when it gets to the end, I just have to turn around, line it up, and off it'll go. Okay, let's fast forward through the rest of this field, and here we go. You've noticed we've had the guides down for the last couple of lanes, so you can see the nice little dash as it's going down the field. So if we weren't using the field guidance system, we can drive up that path, and that should be our 3 meter step away, so that we actually get a nice fill of the field. So we'll see when we turn around, we should get our field guidance system line up with that line. So we use the 4 key to shift it across, so when we turn round, it'll make the next mark. As you can see, field guidance lines up beautifully. Here we go, last stretch, fold up with the X key, deliver it, and now pick up C. First thing we've got to do is create a task. Have a look at the field, just to show that it's been cultivated, and that plough we've got to 0. Remember, it's a 9 meter field, it was at 225, don't need potassium. Small. quick look at the fertilization levels. No, the nitrate levels. We're up at 78. Let's have a quick look at the task. Just to show you, it was set at 225. Down, down. Field work in progress. There we go. Yep, 225. We know we've set it up at 325. There we go, and the field is finished. The AI faulted up and it's going to drive back to the farm now. So let's have a quick look at the nitrogen levels, 112 and out of 120, so actually pretty good in the end. If we look, we're still down here, down below. It says it's got 1% cultivation level. So let's have a look. We've got a couple of little spots, have we? Click on it, we can see those couple of little spots that didn't get picked up, which is too bad. It's more realistic than having a whole build done. And that's it, for today, and that's all the video we're going to show. Thank you very much, and that's it for today. Goodbye.